Health Library. Thank you, Snehal, for shooting this. It's always a pleasure to come. Today's talk, since we have a doctor here of cancer and we have you and everyone, I'd like to begin by sharing approximately what I'm going to cover. What I'm going to cover today in 1 hour on Health Library is what we didn't finish last time: body parts, the reason of illness, thought management, which I teach, why what you think becomes true. You are just now thinking, oh, I should go to an old people's home. Never think that. You're actually telling the universe, my family doesn't want me.
No, my family wants me.
But then don't put that thought into the universe.
Because I want to, you know, give my room to my children.
Irrespective, one roof above your head, children together, grandchildren, is the right feng shui. I teach vastu and feng shui. The best vastu in the world is when you get up every morning with your families, with your loved ones, share what you can, and live with respect.
When I told my children,
ask that.
They said, don't be stupid, yeah. Papa.
Please, the most important thing is what you think of. Exactly that is going to happen. Exactly. Not a little less, not a little more. If you think, oh God, men can't be trusted, do you think marriage, will this one be okay? You've already thought to your universe and you have pulled in someone who's unfaithful because you're vibrating on men are unfaithful. You understand? Or if it's a new house that you want, you have to visualize it, a good house with your family staying in, with a pathway, with a garden, a building, with a swimming pool, whatever you want, with the whole family together. What you think of, that is what is going to happen. Are you with me?
Yeah.
And important, just I'll take it later, important thing is that when you're vibrating, whatever frequency you're vibrating on, that is going to happen. So watch your thoughts and watch your words. We do not even have an iota of how dangerously we talk. I know a mother, I've heard so many of them saying, you know, my children don't listen. I have told him, kabhi na kabhi tu baap banega, then your children will tell you what to do.
Right.
You will know. It's unknowingly a curse. Please watch what you say to your children in a fit of anger, not knowingly. No mother or child or parents ever. But so often we do this unknowingly. You did this to me, you wait and watch. That will happen to you sometime. Don't throw any thought and don't vibrate on any negative thought. It's not going to help. Yes? Okay. Then take it after 5 minutes. No, that time I was finishing them.
You know, before I, it's only a thought.
Yeah.
Before I become a burden on my family. And my family, they have to work.
You have already told the universe you may become a burden on your family. So already you have vibrated in the wrong frequency. No, you have vibrated on that frequency. God is saying tathastu every minute. So you have told God, suppose I vibrate on the thing that my family, I'll be a burden on them. You've already made that pathway. The first day a woman thinks, oh God, is my husband going to be unfaithful? She's already made that pathway. Nothing happens until you once thought of it. So now, cancel, erase from your mind that you can ever be a burden to your family.
You can never.
Don't believe that. Don't believe it. Don't ask for it. However small the houses, let everyone stay together. Irrespective, cases can be millions. Don't vibrate on that. If you vibrate on that, that is going to happen to you. I will write and give it to you.
Okay.
Only what you think of. So first thing, today is going to be an uncluttering of your old thoughts. And the older you are, the stronger our belief system is. Okay, when we believe things are not safe and secure, they will be unsafe and secure. Suppose something doesn't work in life. If plan A didn't work, there are 24 more alphabets. Try B, try C, try D. The day you stop trying, if you go back to Z, start back again to A. The thing is, in life, vibrate on a frequency of never ever giving up. The day you have given up is the day you have finished. What is the difference of time between an Olympic runner? A fraction of a second of the body and they've lost. So that is why don't even the value of a fraction of a second is important. If it's a pregnant woman, she will only know the meaning of 9 months. You all won't. You understand? Till you are delivering. And the value of 1 minute when you have just missed your bus to train. You understand? So it's so important to understand alphabets and the value of time. you are an artist and you choose the colors of your life. Please understand, can you see? Please understand, whatever color you're putting into your life is exactly what you are
getting.
Exactly, you will get back. You throw a ball, it will hit back exactly as much as it is going to come to you. So what colors have come in your life up to today is what you have thought. So I don't want you to have the color of I'll be a burden on my children, okay? You say cancel
and stuff. No,
yeah, cut that thought out, okay? You are basically a light being, okay? If you can just do that. When I am teaching self regeneration, okay? Do any of you all know anything about cells? Anybody have any idea about cell regeneration or what your cells do to your body? Anybody has any idea?
You're made of many...
many cells, yeah. Okay.
Life force.
Cell regeneration is life force. What else? Cell regeneration. Do we all know that we have billions of cells?
Ah, yes.
Okay. Every vibrant atom of our body has cells. Okay. I teach cell regeneration. What is cell regeneration? Every cell has a head, a heart, fingers, feet. So when you're regenerating, you're actually regenerating billions of cells. Now there are two ways of doing it, okay? One main one is by breathing in what you're saying and breathing out. The only way you can regenerate cells are by your thoughts and by your breath. Okay, what you think is going to get capped. Today what I've told you, breathing in, whatever I've said today has got capped in. The first time you said it's not safe, it's got capped. Two times more we have erased it. Now all your cells react to your vibrational thoughts and words. Whatever we say, that is what is going to happen in life. So every time we are vibrating on, what a wonderful day it is, okay? How would you get up in the morning? I taught it before the last time I was in health library. What is the best way to get up in the morning? You vibrate the most the first thing in the morning. Your thought leads the day to what is going to happen. So what is the first thought? The moment you get up, the first thing you do, just open your eyes and just thank the divine for its countless blessings. Just today, the difference between yesterday and today is that you're still breathing and you're alive. Right. And your loved ones are alive with you. Isn't that much enough to be grateful for?
True.
And if you're not grateful, just watch your breath and you'll know what you have to be grateful for. Then touch Mother Earth in the morning like this on the floor and bow down to the four directional laws. It's not religion oriented. Whoever you believe in, let it be Ganeshji, let it be a Kul Guru, a Devi, Mata, Ji, Sai Baba, whatever you believe in. Not somebody else got a new Mercedes, so let me also go to Shirdi. He went to Shirdi and got it. No. When that calling comes from within, whoever, if not just say universal energies or light, okay, eventually we are a connection to the Paramatma. We are nothing but one atom which is connected to our soul, which is connected to the universal soul. So when you finish bowing to the four directional lords, just thank God and just affirm that today is going to be a wonderful day. And think of three things that you badly want in life. Okay? Anything. Let that be your first thought. You're nearest to Titha level. So it's very important. First thought is God's call. First call is God's call. So the first thought. Don't fight. Don't scream. Don't shout. Don't think a negative thought. Okay, I know today is going to be like. However much, begin the day with love, joy. Then when you go to the bathroom, look into the mirror. This is an exercise I've been teaching for years. If this is the mirror, look into the mirror and say, Zenobia, I love you. Take your own name. Just say, I love you. Let your eyes look into your eyes in the mirror. And when your eyes look into your eyes, within one moon cycle, you will be a different person. Because we can't love anybody else unless we love ourselves. So first, just thank God that your beautiful body is there. Okay, send it love and light in the morning, look into the mirror, then start your day and see the magic that starts happening. You can also hold your palms and just look into when you get up after thanking the four directions, look into your palm and just imagine everything is flowing into you. Universal energies are flowing into you, love is flowing into you, light is flowing in, whatever you want. If you have your patience, You can just imagine, you're a wonderful doctor and all the good that you're going to tell them is coming into your head. You know, you generate what you want. And the moment you do that, it's a wonderful journey. Okay? Approximately, this is what our cells are going to look like. We are all beings of light. If we took out our soul and checked our universal soul, I especially get these for you to visualize. When I say in the morning, get up, bow down, I said, look in, imagine golden light on your body. This is how you imagine. If this is you, can you imagine golden light around you? And once you imagine white, gold or light, blue light, you're already protected. Grounding means mother is protected. Light means father has protected you. And believe me, it works. Just give it one try. And all through the day, not only now, but all through the day. Once a day, there's an additional thing if you'd like to do in the morning. We call it Matru Shakti. Just imagine when you think of this light, all four directions, that the light is coming to you. Okay, and it works wonderfully. Believe me, my children don't talk about light or anything, but my son's work is starting and he makes sure he does this every day. He says, Mom, I don't know what it is, but it's working magically. So try it. Just say Matru Shakti or say Mother Energy or say whatever you believe in, but that light pull into you from four sides.
Okay.
And do it at least 10 times a day. Means just before leaving the house, when you reach the office, it takes 2 minutes. Just do it. Pull that energy in this form of light, okay? So you're pulling, can you see, pulling this energy to, just pull the energy to you, okay? Have you thanked your body today? Has anybody like said, get up in the morning and thank for you, thank your body? What's your name?
Firoz Wadia.
Shabash Firoz. Every single day and night, once say thank you to your body, thank your heart for beating. Heart is beating relentlessly. It's not decide, okay, I'll beat after 31 days. I'll do 1 month upvas. Has the heart said that? No, it is pumping relentlessly. 3 minutes and you'll go to the good Lord. The day doesn't beat. So how many of you all, hold your heart, all of you, even everyone on YouTube who's watching, and say, I thank my heart.
I thank my heart.
Thank you, heart.
Thank you, heart.
For beating relentlessly for me.
For pumping air into me.
For keeping all my cells alive. And allowing my lungs to work so wonderfully. Wonderful. I thank my lungs. I thank my chest.
I thank my arms
for working relentlessly for me.
I thank my stomach
and all my vital organs
for working for me
happily forevermore. I thank my legs, and actually touch your legs, for being so wonderful. And taking all my weight all through the day.
I thank my knees
for showing me the direction to walk.
I thank my feet
for taking me in every direction that I want to go. I thank my neck. Please thank your neck. And my shoulders for taking all my burden. I thank this wonderful face and my wonderful eyes for being able to see this beautiful world. Wonderful. And I thank my brain and my mind for being able to think and see right and make all my correct decisions. And I thank my back, lower and upper back, for taking the support of my body and holding me strong and still. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For this wonderful body. Now, it takes not even 1 minute. Every day you don't need to take whole, if you all are getting tired, to say the whole thing. But once a day, at least say body, for 1 second in the day before sleeping, just say thank you that you brought me back safely and securely, shielded and protected, watched, cared and loved in God's light. At least this much just say every day to every part of your body, okay? And once a day, and if something pains, give it more love. If something is hurting, that means what? That part of the body is saying, I'm not getting enough attention.
Okay.
Suppose a child, yeah.
Give more love, you're telling them.
Whatever pains, suppose okay. It's your head, okay. Then for a few seconds, put your hands on your head and love it a little more. Even children, when a child, okay, banging and throwing and screaming and shouting, what it is telling its parents, I want more attention.
Yeah.
You're not giving me enough attention. I want more love. I want more love. I want more attention. That is, the body gives signals, everything. Suddenly you don't get a disease, okay? It's giving, the doctor is here. What is your name, doctor?
Vaidya.
Dr. Vaidya is here. So he will say, somebody doesn't get major blockages in 1 second. The heart is getting troubled and you don't listen. And one blockage and two blockages and three. We pay attention when suddenly we are jogging and we collapse, 90% blockages. Can you imagine if we had handled it at the first, even if it's cancer, first stage, it can be handled so beautifully. But we don't do that. So when the body is giving signals, when the cells that are not regenerating, what happens is we breathe. Okay? Now, we used to breathe when we were children. How many floors did you climb up when you were a child? Happily fast. You could run and climb how many floors? Many. How many? At least two floors, three floors without thinking. Yeah? Now, today if I tell you run up health library fifth floor, you'll go, by the time second floor comes, you're finished. Why? It is only because the air flowing to the heart, the walls are becoming thicker and thicker and less air is flying. The legs that used to walk for days now in mechanics, these days it's so sad, we don't even use our hands to draw curtains. I do vastu for rich and famous houses. They have a button tuck there, windows open, and then all of them have frozen shoulder, a servant. They don't have to even get up and pick up a glass. What's going to happen to your body? It's going to rust. Okay, you have to keep it moving. You have to get up in the morning for health and walk. You have to breathe at least 5 minutes a day. Not the normal breathing, but any pranayama. Any breath, whether it's a simple breath, breathing in for 4 counts, holding for 16, breathing out for 8. Even that much if you do, breathing in 4, can we do it?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4. Now close both nostrils. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now breathe out. Even if this is done 5 minutes a day, you will see an immense difference because the lungs are being activated, so the blood is flushing more, so the cells are working more, so the cells are regenerating, okay? When we exercise, that's what will happen. Anything, suppose we don't move this board for 2 years, it's going to get rusted. The same thing happens to our body when blood is not flowing. Our organs are getting what is frozen shoulder. It means something which is stuck, which is not moving. Okay, anything that happens to your left side, it means the past. And the right side means the future. Yeah. Put it up. Right means the future. Now, who has pain on the left side? You. That means your past problems, you've still not let go of. You've not been able to let go of the pain, of the hurt, of the trauma that has happened to you. Who has more pain on the right side? Who has more pain on the right? You. That means fear of future. What is going to happen to money? What is going to happen to your home? What is going to happen to your relationship? Who else is right side? You. Means, ab kya hone wala hai, you're worried. Okay? So, first understand your left and your right going into the future. Then, suppose your neck is hurting. Okay? Your cells of your neck are not regenerated. It means you don't know how your head is standing. The burden that is there on the neck and the shoulders. There's too much burden. you're not able to take. You know, there's some people who walk like this. Life has burdened them so much in body language and cell regeneration. Whatever is going, if you're pushed too much this way, very few people you'll see standing tall. Have you seen great speakers?
Amitabh
Bachchan. All of them who have reached a height, they're always looking tall. They're not burdened. Okay? If your arms are paining, okay, for any reason, arms means not able to carry the burden of life, what is coming. Okay, if it's lower back, it is money problem. Upper back is support, slip disc. Head means not being able to think right, not being able to make decisions. Okay, you are unable to, your thoughts are not formulated. Most of the time when we visualize what we want a seller's house, but are we sure? How much money do you want for it? You're worried, will you get a right broker? Will you get a new house after that? When you throw all these thoughts in the universe, and I see people for 10 years saying, Garni Bikrai. Or one person in the house loves it so much and their energy is the strongest, you will not be able to sell it. So that way I'm saying thoughts are so, so strong. So like the back, anybody has stomach inconsistency, lots of people have bowel disorders all the time. It means they are emotionally disturbed. Stomach is associated in kinesiology with emotion. Back is money and support. Stomach is emotion. The moment emotional disturbances are there, you'll keep running to the bathroom. Whenever you're upset emotionally, you'll get loose motions. I've always seen gas, something that is emotionally upset. This is the hara, it's the strongest part of the body. And you're holding on to emotion. You make this part powerful and you can reach wherever you can.
What about constipation?
Constipation means inability. Constipation is inability to let go. Let go of. You're holding on. So a cure, since you've asked me for constipation, a good cure which is excellent for cancer also, doctor is dealing in cancer, is to make your body alkaline in the morning. And very people know this easy technique of lime, one drop of honey and hot water. You begin your day with this. And the body has 70% water. So already you're making your body 70% alkaline. And if you do it every single day, you'll be surprised after people starting and saying, "Arey, it's so wonderful." And if for any reason you're not supposed to have the honey, then at least do hot water in lime. Okay? For some reason, sometimes in myeloma or something, they say, "I don't want you." If the growth is there, you don't want sweet. But please, one drop of honey won't do you any harm. One drop of honey, hot water, whether you have a problem or not, it's the best thing for your entire body. Compared to all the fancy 1,000 rupees and 10,000 rupee vitamins and this to detoxify and this. This is the best detoxification. Pure water in this. You drink 7 glasses of water a day, minimum. And nothing will go wrong with you, minimum. Okay, and at least 5 liters if you can. And if you want to lose weight, before food. Constipation, 1 glass of water before food. And isabgol before food. It works very well. What happens is it goes into the lining and whatever oily things you eat, it doesn't let it stick. People take isabgol after food and say it's not working. Try it before food. A, it will give you a fullness so you won't eat so much, so you won't put on weight. And 1 glass of water before food and it's wonderful. Otherwise, papaya is very good to eat for constipation, whatever medicines, whatever your Ayurveda or your doctor gives. Make sure you give it a break. Anything should not get into a habit. Give it a break, eat papaya for some days, then take the tablets again so your body doesn't get immune. The cells have to be distracted. It should not have any order. They'll say, "Oh God, what's happening?" You have to surprise your body cells to doing new things, you are asking.
Between having my lunch or dinner, I have water also. How can I?
In between, don't have. Okay. Have it half an hour after food or have water at least 10 minutes to half an hour before food. Have 2 glasses, believe me. You will be able to eat just enough and eat with your eyes. Don't eat with your hands and mouth most of the time. Try it. And those that have had bariatric surgeries, there is such a simple cure for it, people don't know. It's amazing.
What is that?
Bariatric surgery is when they cut your stomach to make you thin.
Oh.
So what the difference in bariatric, which even some doctors don't stress, is that you can eat as much as you want, but you have to eat with a baby spoon because you have a baby's stomach. So the moment people eat with big spoons and then they say we eat and we vomit, the doctor is not good, I think I didn't do the surgery properly, my body is not. You have to learn to eat like you feed a little baby. You try baby, big spoon, the baby will go burp. That way you are a baby once you've had a bariatric surgery. So if you have any friends or anyone on YouTube who doesn't know about this, please try. You have to chew 20 times and eat with a small spoon. And you can eat a full bowl, believe me. You can eat loads, you'll be surprised how the body will be able to
take. What about gaining weight?
Gaining weight. I rarely get asked this, but gaining weight, eat mangoes, eat banana, eat everything fatty that you want. But very few people really need to gain weight.
Yeah, I agree.
So if weight is such a thing that 90% most of people, unless, and when you have lost weight, it could be a medical reason, so check it out. And the moment you suddenly lose weight, watch out for that.
Yeah.
Okay? Mm. Because that means the universe is giving you a signal. Watch. Whenever there's a sudden difference in anything, you have to again reassure. If it's a good doctor, he will always check and ask history of what has happened suddenly. And I lost about 10 kilos suddenly in a year, and all my in-laws, my family was getting worried. And when I went back to my teacher who does breathing for me, I had started Brahma Vidya. And my teacher said, after all the tests, that forget about it, it's your breathing that is. So you lose fabulous weight with Brahma Vidya. It's lovely, it's called Brahma Vidya Sadaksan. You can look at it on YouTube. Fabulous breathing techniques. It's nothing to do with Brahma Kumari. It's just a association that teaches you free, that teaches you how to
breathe
with lessons for 5 months. It's amazing every Sunday. And I lost amazing weight and I've not put it on. Now, after these body parts that I talked about, lungs we were talking about. Lungs is grief. Okay, when there's immense grief in the heart, water fills in the lungs. When there's cancer, it's one cause only. Suppressed emotion. Cancer is emotion which has been dabbed for years. You have not been able to say what you are saying. So there are lots of times when women say, I'm vegetarian, I've not eaten chicken, I'm Jain and this, why did I get it? Sometimes it's because there is amazing suppression on every cell. So even in Hinduja Hospital, I've been making people write for hours and hours letters of anger. The moment you want to get cured, there's such a easy way. I mean, it's sad, I wish I could scream it to the whole world. Take a paper, write down everything that made you angry. Tear it up there and then, either burn it,
flush it,
tear it, or flush it down immediately. Do that for 21 days and then go and check your blood reports. You will be so surprised. So surprised. The moment you do it, your cancer cells balance. We all have cancer in our body. When it goes to an erratic rational, then we call it myeloma, metastasis, or everything else. But most important is that I don't know if you know this doctor, you're dealing in cancer, just try it with one patient. Make them sit in your clinic. You're a scientist. Oh, okay, wonderful. That's even better. Then this will excite you even more. Please try it. I've worked it for 20 years and I've seen it work. It's all in the mind. Your cancer is first not in your body, you've thought of it. So the moment you release the anger, release the venom, forgive whatever has happened, make a nice happy state, move on, your body will start growing. My teacher Louis Hay, wonderful teacher, it's a book to read,
Heal Yourself.
You Can Heal Yourself. They say immensely that the moment you change a state, for instance, diabetes comes with one reason and that is shock. Everyone who's got diabetes most of the time has had one shocking instance in life which has shaken them up and then diabetes has come. But the moment you write anger, the moment you write letters of anger, the moment you release,
just write and tear it off.
Write
every day, whatever problem.
Even if you don't have, I write my letters every day, even now. Something or the other disturb. Believe me, you'll get a glow on your face. Your face, people will start asking you, kya kya hai? People will like being near you. Good people will start coming near you. It's because you have aligned all your cells. You have told the universe what you attract, exactly what you want that you attract. Okay? So please try letters of anger. One day I would like to come 1 hour and make all of you all write it.
Yeah,
it is so amazing when you write. remove every cell memory. We have gone, it's called timeline. It could be 10 years ago that something upset you and then you've forgotten and you've covered it up. But it's there. So you have to go back to that incident, write about it, and after writing, when you burn it, say, I release all these memories. Easily and effortlessly. The moment you release it, suddenly people who get asthma are able to breathe. Suddenly your bowel motions will start moving. Suddenly your eyes will glow. Please release all the pain and anger in your body.
Yes. About the degeneration of eyes.
Degeneration of eyes. You know, eyes generate the quickest. There are different parts of the body in my cell regeneration where I teach. Otherwise you can check at Zenobia Khodaiji 98203-08163. Eyes generate the quickest. Eyes can regenerate the most quickly. But we don't realize that. So the best thing is go to your doctor, do your eye exercises, don't wear spectacles. What most of the time, why the eyes degenerate, we wear such heavy magnifying glasses ke hum bahut achha dikhta hai. So our eye ka cell say, fine, you don't want me to work, next time get a bigger one, next time get a bigger glass, but time will come when the doctor will say there are no more bigger magnifier. Then you have to start working the eyes, you have to start doing your eye exercises, you have to start making. And when eye pain happens, means we don't like what we are seeing in life. What is happening to us, we don't like resonating to it. You understand? It's like your heart trouble. First time you got a little heart trouble, you didn't take much, this thing. Doctor said, one pill take, it's wonderful, you get an aspirin. Lelia, you're absolutely fine. Sometime you get bigger. Doctor said, don't worry, two will take. Then you will say three. But you will not get up in the morning and jog. You will not do your pranayama. Taking the tablet is much easier to do. Believe me, I was in Australia teaching last week, and the family friend of ours came the other day. And at that house, as we took out his bag where he was saying, I suddenly said, come up. He said, no, I run up 7 floors. I said, you've just flown it from Australia? He said, yes, I want my heart. He's never attended my seminar, but that man is so fit. He said, no, I got 7 floors. Wow, you take the bag up, all 4 of us. Took the bag up, and before we reached the 7th floor, he was up. No. So amazing. It could be the story of your life, but you never walk steps. You'll grumble, lifting eye. Start walking at least 2 floors a day. If you live on the 10th floor, walk up 2 floors and then take the lift or got up 8. If you live on town floors, your building will have steps. Run up and run down. Okay. If you are lazy to walk, at least run up and run down. Best is walking up steps. If you don't have heart trouble, if you have any major illness, check with your doctor. And don't walk after food immediately. This is one wrong thing that gives more trouble. Give it a period of half an hour, 40 minutes, and then have your walks. People eat and run. Suddenly they get attacked, suddenly they get problems. Be very careful in how you respect and love this body. This body loves you. From the day you've been born, it's been loving you and looking after you. You've never even said once thank you to your heart. Today is probably, I think, the first time you all have all held your hearts and say thank you. How old are you?
I'm 85.
Okay. Oh. In 85 years, please put a face on him. This is the first time, I'm sure, that you have said thank you, heart.
Thank you, 85 years it has done for you,
but we've not said thank you, taken it for granted, okay? Everything that you take for granted is not good, whether it's relationship, whether it's love, you have to work at everything. Staticity means death. Stale things in a room means the room will become stale, no hava. No hava in your body means you're dead, a dead body will stink. So anything that doesn't move and is too still and not moving, for a long time it will create negative energy. And that doesn't mean stillness. If you sit still and breathe, it's fine. But if you stop breathing, total stillness of anything means death. So if there's total stillness and no love in your relationship, you're not giving out love. And then you're saying, she doesn't love me, she doesn't love me, he doesn't love me. But what have you given? You give only what you get. And you get only what you give.
If you just said you have to give. But suppose I give something and a negative response comes, then how to deal with that?
It means you've given up the A to Z. Then there's a B, there's a C, there's a D, there's a E. Don't give up.
No, madam, it's not that. He's giving you the condition.
No, even if you give unconditionally and it doesn't happen, give second time unconditionally. Because understand that vibrate from the heart. The moment you're giving something, give it to the heart of that person. If you start talking to the soul, heart and the golden aura that I told you, sky will be the limit. You don't even know the power of thanking your body. Thank yourselves. Say every day, I love my body. Say,
I love my body.
Gratitude is the vitamin for the soul. Please live in the mode of gratitude. Gratitude for everything. Gratitude for your house, your family, your breath, your body that's got up, your eyes, the situation you're in, your job, your loved ones, everything. Just stay in the mode of gratitude and it's wonderful. And I have a lovely group, a WhatsApp and a YouTube group. Please contact me on 98203-08163 and I'll add you into the group. Every day we tell you one thing to be grateful for. You have to WhatsApp. Today I give you one subject. It can be the universe, earth, friends, body, teachers, your partners, your children. Every day we give one thing. So when 3 months go, suddenly you say, wow, actually God has given me a lot. I've only not said shukrana for it.
Good morning.
Okay, smile and say good morning. The difference between breakfast, lunch and dinner. This is about breakfast, lunch and dinner. If you have small breakfast, bigger lunch and big dinner, you're going to be like Mr. Fat. And if you have big breakfast, medium lunch and small dinner, it's going to be much better for you. It's a wrong myth that if I don't eat in the morning, you know, I'll lose a lot of weight. No, the body needs. You don't burn out the food in the night. They're such simple things. In my WhatsApp group, I even put tips on health. They're very, very important. Okay? These are all the foods that are alkaline. Broccoli. Things that are very, very good for the body for being alkaline. Okay? If you're a vegan and don't eat, why I put these on the YouTube, people can see. These are all foods that are for vegans. Those who don't eat milk, all this helps in the milk, okay? This should be used every day. Have avocados, have garlic, have tomatoes, have cucumbers, kale. I brought kale and I'm growing kale in my garden. It grows beautifully. Grapefruits. Please make sure that in the mornings, if any problem have or don't have, start the day with kothmir and kari patta. In your toast, on your breakfast, or put it like a pani puri ka water and drink it, carry it with your work with you, put a cucumber slice in it. The moment you eat kari patta and kothmir, at least kari patta, eat at least 31 a day, you will be surprised. Your urine will flush out, things will be right.
Grapefruit is a contraindicatory for statin. Statin and grapefruit don't go together.
No, no. For liver function, each fruit
is... No, that is true, but grapefruit is contraindicated for those who are taking statin, all statin drinks.
But it can be eaten also, as grapefruit is a wonderful fruit to eat.
Except the person should not on statin.
On, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yes,
person who's taking statin should not. But the person who's statin will be told from the beginning what not to take. It's like if you have Parsis, have certain medicines which they are not allowed to take. When they have low sulfur. So that is different. This I'm talking about absolutely normal people. Please don't mix fruits together. There is one saying my guru used to teach me. Papaya, eat a full papaya. Banana, eat a full banana. This mixing of fruits, once in a while, go have a fruit juice. It doesn't matter, mix. But on every day, you know, parents feel, chalo, I'll eat a fruit. Mere bete ko angur bhi dal ke do, thoda apple bhi kaat ke do. Don't make the cocktail. It'll be better if you cut 3 bananas and give if you want.
Yeah.
If they have a large appetite. And fruits should be eaten before 12 o'clock. Try. They work like magic. Banana is diamond in the morning, silver in the afternoon, and absolutely copper in the night. Don't have it. Okay? These are just interesting things for you to know, which is what I'd like to share.
How to avoid overeating?
How to eat with your eyes. Okay. Eat smaller meals for overeating if you don't want to go fat. Water before. And fill your body with water and needs. Like, we make pani puri ka pani and keep once in a while, you know, add a little bit of something sweet to it to give it instead of Pepsis and Cokes and any aerated drinks. Any aerated drinks, I won't take names, but any aerated drinks, be little careful, don't overdo it with your children. Few, it's lovely. Go to party, enjoy a Coke, enjoy a Pepsi. But over-imbalancing it is not good. When you're having four glasses a day, five glasses a day, you know, anything in an imbalance is not good. Okay? And overeating, there is a lovely diet. I will WhatsApp it to you. Try and follow it. Fill up your stomach in the morning. Avoid fattening things. It should be more if you want to use weight. Have coconut water. Have healthy things for your body. And anything that makes you fat, please don't have it. And I don't need to tell you, everybody knows what makes you fat.
Sugar.
The fruits, sugar that makes you fat. Fruits that make you fat. Have one mango, but in mango season, people will have three glasses of mango juice. That's when you suddenly put on. And every 1 kilo that you put on is actually like two bags of sugar on your feet. That much weight which you're climbing up 10 floors. That much trouble it gives to the body. Watch your
breath. But it's not fattening.
Overdoing of it is fattening. A little bit of ghee is okay.
No, buy 1 teaspoon of butter.
Anything in a balance, unless the doctors told you not to eat it. No one is better informed about your body than your family doctor. Okay? Foods that you should eat every day. These are serotines which are very good, which you can add into your body. One apple a day, they say, keeps the doctor away. So there's a saying, when the doctor's wife eats the apple a day, what will happen? She'll keep the doctor away. Though. It's about your... It's just laughing. It's about you. Apple is a healthy fruit. But believe me, a banana a day also will keep the doctor away. And a pear a day also will keep the doctor away. Fresh fruits, is the saying goes, meaning that fresh fruits should go into your body. Instead of having popcorn and instead of having big breads and lots of maida in your body. Please eat fresh things. It will make your body very good. Pumpkin seeds are very good. For a headache, this is a lovely... Don't pop pills into your body. Okay? 10 to 12 almonds, okay, is as good as one aspirin. People don't know this. Okay? For migraines. Badam is good too. Kaju will only increase your waistline. Okay? Badams, people think, are eating very, very high, very, very good, and I've seen people sit for 3 hours moving, eating half a kilo of badams. Please don't overdo it, okay?
Walnuts.
Please. Anything. Have 4 walnuts a day, good for your brain, good for your hair. But make sure, the one thing you understand today, after today's 1 hour talk on Health Library, that imbalance of anything, what the Bhagavad Gita taught us, is not good. 1 kilo of badam together is not good. A big bunch of kajus all together one day is not good. It'll take you 3 months to get rid of that weight. Oh. Any overdoing of anything is not good. Onions are very good, but one thing I'd like to share with you about onions is that from times immemorial, onions was used as an antiseptic during wars. They were kept during the plague so that they would absorb all the negativity, you know. So be very careful not to eat onions, and even if it's a 5-star hotel or if it's left open on the road next to a gutter or sewage, suddenly you're going to put negative cells and energies into your body. Onion kept open for more than 5-10 hours is, and when people have a wedding, they cut onions 10 hours before for the cooking. You don't know there where the mosquitoes are there. What is, so as far as possible, don't eat raita outside. Don't eat onions which have been kept open. Okay? Yeah. Not too much oil. Okay?
Onions should never be cooked also, no? Like Pasi do.
Actually, all food, if you could always have raw, is the best thing in the world. Everything can be cooked, but I'm saying that really people who lived healthily and lived for 100 years, the more raw you eat, wash it properly and eat it, because today there are pesticides, things. Okay, don't put too much potassium permanganate because that's going to go into your body.
Yeah.
Okay, little bit, just nicely wash it with water. And the important thing about food is love. Please make sure that your wives, your families cook with love. I cook my own food. Okay, please remember that when your child asks for one more roti, whoever you've kept for cooking, she says, oh God, I have to make one more roti. The maid will say, then she'll see, arey aata nahi hai, chalo aata gundne ka hai. Then she'll roll it for your son. And then she'll say, oh God, kal do maangne wala hai kya? From tomorrow he's going to eat more. Can you imagine the negativeness that has gone when your son is eating? And when a grandmother is told, ek aur roti, she'll run into the kitchen, make it bigger, put more ghee. and give it. Why we say grandmother's foods is so nice, and parents, because that love goes into it. In this time of videos and digital thing, what we are missing in ourselves is love. What we all want is the word parva, love and attention. Parva is another word in Hindi for care and concern. And what do we want at the end of the day? When we come home, a wife gives lovingly a cup of tea. All of us, by and large, humans don't have these unbelievable wants. We want that we come home, we are accepted. We don't come home and they say, oh God, ye ghar aa gaya hai abhi. You know, that's what we don't want, correct? We all want to be loved. So that, you try and give it. If it's not in your house, you ask me a question. Uh-huh. Even if one fortune changes a state, it changes. So you be the first one to start changing that. Get a little bit of love, get a little bit of joy, get a little bit of this thing. Start doing kind things. Every cell of that person, however harsh, will react when they are told, thank you, Achai Achiti. Thank you, the food was good today. Thank you, all these years you have been putting my wallet straight, folding my clothes. The wife must have been doing, like he has lived 85 years. For 20 years of your marriage, the wife is doing everything. You haven't ever looked into her eyes and say, thank you. How many husbands, all those that are watching on YouTube today, go to your wives, just thank them for one good thing they've done. Bringing up your children all these years, giving you food on time, looking after your house, looking after your relatives, your mother-in-law. You all have probably never, never used the word thank you. Please do it. Flax seeds are amazing. Please start using flaxseed. Flaxseed oil, one drop in a salad. If your children don't eat it, flax seeds do wonders. Just inculcate them in your life. It's such a simple way of getting well. But we don't do it. We want these fancy bottles with flaxseed written on it. It will not even have that much content of you eating one, two spoons. But you will love to buy those expensive things because they've said it'll give this. Use your common sense sometimes. Rajma, we fight for broccoli and today broccoli is not there. Rajma is the best. Shilpa Shetty has written such a wonderful book on health. Please take the trouble to go on, I don't know, Amazon or wherever it is and buy it. It's a mind-blowing book. Please get it here in Help Library and all of your, or I'll buy one and send it to you all. Fabulous book. And Rajma is so, so important. So important for health. Please inculcate Rajma into your life. Okay, it might sound very basic. Natural remedies for cough also, tulsi, adrak, please use all these, all of them. For treatment for arthritis, this is actually good not only for arthritis but for everything. Taj powder is so, cinnamon is so good for your body. Along with a drop of honey, lime and water, you can add, some people add just a pinch, it hasn't to be much, because then it'll be garam for you. People think, oh, I lost weight, so I'll take one more spoon, two more spoons. No. One pinch, four times a day you drink in a little bit of hot water. You know, Chinese, after food, you've always seen them. What are they doing? Why are they so nice and slim? They're always washing off their fat by drinking something hot. A drop of cinnamon is fabulous. Amazing. And believe me, it took years for me. All my gurus have taught me these secrets. Please just don't listen to it and put it in shelf knowledge. Let it be self-knowledge. When we buy big books and we read them and we say, wow, what a lovely author and wow, what a lovely knowledge. But then you will not go home and drink that cinnamon powder. You will only tell everybody how wonderful it is.
For a natural medicine for diabetes.
Absolutely, absolutely. We haven't touched diabetes yet. But Sukka, we'll touch it now, doctor. Cinnamon, one drop of cinnamon is good. Also, a little bit of bhindi in a little bit of water. Cut bhindi on both sides with your hand, put it in a little water and just drink it. Very good for diabetes, very good for constipation. Have sukka methi, either like that or soak it overnight, very good. You want to say something about cinnamon?
Yes, it needs to be used in hot water or hot tea.
Correct.
It contains some chemicals which correct. Are toxic.
Always in warm, I didn't say cold water, in hot tea hot, I said. Okay. So it's a nice point he brought up that please don't have cinnamon powder kaccha. Please have it in warm water, which we were talking about in your tea. Home remedies for diabetes. Okay, sukka methi is very good, bhindi ka water is very good is seeds, very good is curry leaves, that is curry patta. Please chew curry patta. You don't know the value of curry patta. Your skin will go, your hair will start becoming black again, your body will get revitalized, your urine will start going again. The immense power of curry patta, a little bit of tulsi also. That's why easiest, if you can't do too many things, in your one bottle of water, cut one piece of kakri, just cut it into two pieces and put it in, one or two tulsi ka leaves and curry patta. Just put it in if you can't. At least they will absorb and that water goes into your body. And of course, if you can put a drop of cinnamon in your body, your weight will go like, just like that. Very good for diabetes is karela. And this is a wrong saying that chee, karela is bitter. It's not. You can make the most lovely vegetables. Soak the karela, cut it, squeeze out the water and that bitterness will go, and eat the vegetable. It's a very, very, very good vegetable to eat. Okay. Now these are foods I want to show you. You don't have to overdo. Pani puri, yeah. Don't overdo. Puris, don't overdo. Mm-hmm. Too much of chola gets gas, don't overdo. Your body deserves the best. So the next time you're going to the best seat in the theater and you want to spend 350 rupees to buy the best seat, no. Buy the 150 rupees seat, but what goes into your mouth, spend money on yourself. Like I said, love yourself. Many of us think, oh God, badam, let me take the cheapest chalega. You know, at least I'm eating it. Eat this much, but eat good, eat well. Are you with me?
Yes.
Whatever you're eating for your children, please spend on yourself. Don't be conscious on yourself. You are the most important person in your life.
Yeah.
And if you're not going to love yourself and make yourself the most important, your mind the most important, your thought the most important, then nothing is going to help, okay? For insomnia, 2 spoons of fenugreek seeds, 1 teaspoon of honey. Please try this out.
Which seeds?
Fenugreek.
Methi.
Very, very, very good. Methi. And for sleeping, there's a lovely thing. Say thank you to God. Count from 100 backwards. By the time you come, you'll be followed. And if it still doesn't have, say one and whom you love the most. Say, what is your son's name? We love our children the most. Can someone give me the child's name?
I'm not married.
Okay, sorry. You're not. Anybody has a child, girl or boy?
Nikhil.
Nikhil, okay. So what he will sleep and say? Nikhil 100. Bless him. You're blessing that with when you're counting. So bless him 100. Bless him 99. Bless him 98. The moment you bless the person you love, by the time you come to one, you'll be completely trying. Wonders it works. Wonders.
So how does one make juice of this fenugreek?
No, soak the fenugreek seeds, mash it in and water. Yeah, and even if you can't soak, swallow 1 teaspoon of honey, drink it at night. The essence of honey and jaggery, instead of having all these stupid sugars, inculcate jaggery. The amount of good jaggery does, you have no idea. Eat a little bit of jaggery after your food, it will not do you any harm. Okay? For asthma, it's gooseberry, which is amla, 1 teaspoon of honey, mix in the morning and have.
My mother has.
Very. Make sure you do this for them. Another thing for people, this is of course a psychic cure, which one of my healing teachers taught me, that those that have asthma, the parents should put 11 chalks, you know these chalks?
Mm-hmm.
About pilikte chalks. That chalk, put them under your mattress, under the lungs where the child sleeps. Somehow it will absorb the negation. It's a wonderful cure. Bless it. Take your guru's name. Put the chalk under the mattress. Try it. I've seen it work a million times over. Migraine being done. Garlic is very good for diabetes. Garlic is very good for even any kind of blood pressure or cholesterol. Okay. For acne or for skin problems, oats are very good. Now one thing. Like I told you, body parts, head, the neck is for burden, the back when you have pain it means relationship and money problems, stomach is your emotions, with these that way. Skin means territory. It means the borderline of your life is in trouble. Your husband could be your lifeline, so maybe some relationship problem. And skin means property. It means, you know, it's the covering of your body. So something that is covering your life has been shaken up. That's when you get psoriasis, you get skin problems. means some property issue which is eating you up.
Ma'am, some boil it comes and goes. So
that is little different. That is heat in your body.
Okay.
That is anger which is suppressed and taken out, suppressed and taken out. But the whole skin, this will be very interesting for you. What I'm sharing with you is really, really my advanced kinesiology. Where your whole skin is your territory. So the moment people have skin problems, you can ask them what property problems you have. First thing, ask them to release it. Pray to their pittas. Ask them to bless the souls that have given them that property. Ask for forgiveness if any soul has been hurt. And come mentally to terms with whatever is there. Don't keep anger in your body towards properties and this issue. Depression, cardamom is very good for it. Okay? Now, depression is actually an ungratefulness to the universe for what it has given you. Okay? It's like gloating on attention. And some people, when they are depressed, the family says, "Arey, aapko kya ho gaya? Chalo thoda ye bhi." So you're loving the attention, so you're being more depressed. I had a lady who was cured of cancer, and then suddenly she said, "Ab healing mat dena, don't give anything." Why? She said, "Then my husband will go back to that woman again. Now my family is okay, they've come to me." So sicknesses are also of the mind. The body decides that if this happens, this is going to happen to me. So first, negate all in, all negativity. Depression, yeah, get out. Depression is a curse. Don't do it. Don't keep it, not for a second, not for a minute, not for an hour. Okay, you have no right when God has given you such a beautiful body. He's given you so much to be grateful for. These hands, food, clothing, shelter. See the people on the road who are there, who have nothing in life. So what we have, just shukrana. Look into your eyes every morning and just say thank you. You will never be depressed. Never. Vertigo, then there are corns. There are lots of diseases. For ulcers, it is cabbage, carrot and celery juice. Okay? I've just put these so on Health Library. Whoever wants whatever, they can take all these. Stress reliever is excellent. Bunch of spinach, cucumber, celery and lemon. Just make this little, this thing. How much? Okay. 5 minutes. I'll just go through.
No, you can carry.
A book a day keeps stupidity away. Please read one book. We know nothing and we will start shouting, you know, "I read this in this newspaper." Don't give your opinions. Whenever you don't know anything, especially about health, go back, read a book or go onto the net or read them. It's very important. Okay? Gratitude is what I always say. Be grateful, be grateful, be grateful. Once in a while, write a note to yourself. Write down to yourself a thankfulness for the good things. Make a small little diary of gratitude to yourself. Every day, write one good thing. That's why I have this WhatsApp group on 98203-08163, where I will teach you. WhatsApp to me, Zenobia, add me onto your group, and it is wonderful. Every day you will have to believe in yourself, and you are what you believe yourself to be. So if you believe I'm an idiot, you're an idiot. If you don't believe you're an idiot, you are not an idiot. Imagine a new story for your life and start living that new story. Eating things that mentally strong people do. Okay? And the last I would really like you to do is contact me on 98203-08163 and on 98209-12528. May God bring love, luck and joy into your lives. Please follow what I said. Get up in the morning, look into the mirror, look into your eyes, eat well, eat a heavy breakfast, a light lunch, make sure you're happy. Thank your wives and husbands once a day for what they are doing. Keep gratefulness in your life and enjoy this beautiful life. Breathe well, have a walk once a day and enjoy yourselves. Thank you.
Thank you.